hit the ball higher and straighter from the fairway, the sand, and the rough. Order the hybrid approach wedge, risk-free for only $99. Visit us at hwedge.com.
One of the best things you can do over the next 30 days to really improve your game is to actually take a look at your golf bag and make sure you've got the right clubs for the distance gaps that you need to fill. One of the things I'd suggest doing is going to see your local PGA professional or maybe a golf retailer who has really good equipment like we have here at Eagle Springs, where we've got the Flight Scope launch monitor, which can help you dial in your spin rates, your launch angles, and make sure that you've got a nice consistent gap between each club. You know, one of the things I see a lot, for example, is golfers who carry a 3-wood when they shouldn't carry a 3-wood. So when the swing speed is slower, the 3-wood doesn't have enough loft to the face to create enough carry. And so when your swing speed's a little slower, having a 4-wood or a 5-wood is oftentimes a better option. Another thing we see is that many golfers maybe don't need to carry a full set of 14 clubs. Because the distance gaps are so close together, it makes it confusing and it actually makes it harder to pick the right club. So you might carry 12 clubs or 11 clubs, but that's going to create a better spacing, and so you know you have 8 yards different per club, and that's going to make it a lot easier to make a really, really confident club selection. You know, one of the things you should really take into consideration when you're fine-tuning your bag is the golf course that you play and what's needed around your course. Does it have a lot of forced carries, or can you roll the ball a lot? For example, I use 3 wedges because I find that that gives me the best ability to get around the course that I play. You want to look at the bounce on the wedges. Do you have firm fairways or soft fairways? A good fitter can help you dial those things in. Maybe you want to get rid of your 4-iron or your 5-iron even at this point and move to a hybrid club. And speaking of hybrids, you got to make sure that you understand not every manufacturer's 4-hybrid or 5-hybrid has the same loft. So using a launch monitor like the Flight Scope, you can dial in the distance gaps without really paying so much attention to the loft on the club. Just make sure that it fills in the gaps that you need. So take the next 30 days to really dial in your bag, and it may take that long to get it all right, but make sure you've got the right wedges, make sure you've got the right shafts in your clubs, make sure you've got the right combination of long irons versus hybrids for your golf course that you play. And if you do that over the next 30 days, I guarantee your scores will improve.